You went back to the calling women bitches and...
Let me explain to you. It's hard to let go of something that you've been accustomed to your whole life.
Your whole life.
And something that you really trying to work on. And it's sometimes where it's like, oh, man, I had a backslid. It used to be a time when my music was everything. You know, Snoop's music, his songs, his words. But once you become a grown man and you realize that your words have power.
The repercussions.
And you have power. Then you have to pull back. And even me and Pac got into it because he was like, he wanted me to stay gangster. And I was like, cuz, I got a baby on the way.
Yes.
I just beat a murder case. I have a lot to live for.
Right.
He had no kids.
Pac and I used to get into his usage of bitch and hoe.
Right.
We got into it hardcore.
I'm because he could about give you this beautiful record.
Yes.
And then turn around.
And I was like, what are you doing? And he's like, I'm not talking about you.
Ooh.
And it's we was torn though. Like
right,
to be able to do this and that. It's like he wasn't talking about you, but he had to talk to those that was out there.
Yeah.
So here's the thing though. He tried his best to define for me
bitch and hoe.
How he was walking his walk.
He tried to define for me the difference, which of course never
it really made no sense at all.
Right. So you're saying your definition would make no sense.
I'm not going to try to explain it to you.
Okay, good.
Because I felt like in the beginning, that was a word that was brainwashed, that was taught to me.
Right.
And I just misused it. And I just kept just throwing it out there. And I seen it came back to me on the Gayle incident.
Yeah.
Because I had got rid of it to a certain extent. And mama only caught it one time.
Right.
2 years ago, I put out a gospel album.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
A whole album that was just gospel clean. Nobody wanted to talk about.